by far my favorite stuff in the world is Gorilla Glue, because you can fix anything with this stuff. So let me show you my airplane. I have flown this for at least 3 or 4 months, and I have yet to crash it. But it gets beat up all the time because it's called hangar rash when you drop it and it gets banged up in your car and things like that. So let me show you how to fix styrofoam on these little styrofoam airplanes. And this is a critical skill for anybody that's flying RC airplanes, especially the new foamies. And it is super easy using Gorilla Glue. The reason Gorilla Glue is so amazing is because it acts like epoxy, but instead of using some crazy chemical as the activator, it uses water. So the other thing is a lot of people will tell you not to use Gorilla Glue with styrofoam because it might eat the styrofoam a little bit, but it's so minuscule that it doesn't matter. And the greatest part about it is when Gorilla Glue dries, it basically turns into styrofoam. It turns into this foamy, super hard mass. So it's perfect for styrofoam. So all I did was take a little bit of Gorilla Glue and I put it on my joint where I want it to stick, right? And I put it on there, and this just makes sure that it's spread out everywhere I need it, inside where I want it to actually fix itself. Now all I do is spray everything with water. A little bit of water, just a tiny bit. It doesn't even really need that much, but water is the actual activator for Gorilla Glue. And then I'm going to put my piece on where it's supposed to be. Now I do have to clamp this down because Gorilla Glue, when the water hits it and activates it, it's because it's polyethylene. It actually expands, so it would just like and push the part apart, but I don't want to do that, so that's why I'm going to clamp it down. But check it out. Look how much like time and how easy this is. As opposed to epoxy, you either have to go really fast or just be absolutely meticulous. But with the Gorilla Glue, man, slap it on there, throw some water on there, and this is even going to start to activate for probably another 2 minutes or so. You can actually start to see the bubbles just a tiny bit. But now all I have to do is clamp it down, man, and I'm good to go. And that's it.